This will be a test of firmware 8.0 taking a freeway exit. We have one coming up just around the corner. As you can see on the instrument cluster, it's showing the black Kia that's up ahead of us and the angle in which it was traveling. Somewhat surprised that it wasn't displaying more vehicles than it previously did. Cars that were right around me that would normally show all around me at a stoplight did not show up, but we will test that more later. And as you can see, nav shows we will be taking this exit coming up. Tesla said in 8.0 you would have to turn on your turn signal, so turn signal's on. Has now taken the freeway exit, but it is not slowing down at all. And it was going to take that turn doing 60 miles an hour. That was a little nerve-wracking, especially on a wet road. It did eventually take the turn, though. We're going to get back on the freeway, turn around, and take the next. So I'm going to change. Wow, this is really late. Turn signals on. Car is moving over, but of course there's a vehicle in front of us. So we're slowing down for the vehicle in front of us. Kind of killed that test. Okay, cancel it. Let's do it again, going back towards that windy ramp again. These are the two closest ones available. This time I'm going to, before I have the car exit the freeway, I will turn the speed down to say 50, even though it's a little wet out. It'll be a lot easier to take that ramp at 50 than it would 60, and then I can leave autopilot active longer to see if it would be willing to slow the car down at all, or if it's just going to maintain speed on the exit. Now, apparently in firmware 8.1 they said you wouldn't even have to use the turn stalk. Car would, if you have something in nav, the car would take the exit automatically. Okay, turn signal's on. Speed's locked in at 50. Let's see if it's gonna. Alright, it's taking the exit. I'm ready to take over just in case here. Alright, hold steering wheel, got it. But it is slowing us 40, 39, it's hesitating. 38, and it just kept going. And it took, well, I guess I did have my right signal on, so it went right, and it did not show or display the vehicles that were in front of me on that, which I can tell you on past times I've taken that exit, it did. So, might as well make a U-turn, go around, try it again. This is going to be a longer, more gradual, curvy exit. Showed the wrong angle of which the semi-truck was traveling, and now autopilot's waving us off the road, even though it's displaying the lines fine. Showing two vehicles. I'm gonna have to change lanes. And it did so very snappily this time. taking the exit. I'm going to slow it down to 50 manually. Speed limit's 35 on the exit. Hold steering wheel. Couldn't handle it. Well, actually, it's still doing it, but let's see what's happening here. All right, slowness down. Nope, I'm taking control. We're weaving all over the place. Nice so far. It's taking the exits, but it's not slowing down at a reasonable enough speed to be able to also maintain control. It's a rainy day. This will be the last freeway exit test. Alright, it's taking the exit. This one's pretty gradual. Let's see what the stoppage is, and it is not slowing down at all. Okay, that's good to know. Even though the car will take the immediate exit that you have planned when you have the turn signal on, be prepared to slow down and then stop the vehicle as quickly as you can. So it's impressive. It's taking the exits. Now they just need to figure out how to get the car to start slowing down more so on those exits.
Smile, cheese.